the application of computational protein ligand docking on the denaturation of beta amyloid for Alzheimer's disease, a George Mason University Department of Bioengineering project by Hanno Kamine, Jamie Lee, Russell Rudd, Patrick Murphy, and David Peel.
What is Alzheimer's disease? Alzheimer's disease is the most common form of dementia, or a decline in mental ability severe enough to interfere with daily life. One of the most significant effects of Alzheimer's disease is chronic memory loss. Not to be confused with senility or brain damage, Alzheimer's disease hinders human ability to focus and reason in their everyday lives. While this extreme condition sounds rare, it is fairly common. 5.3 million US residents, as well as an estimated 44 million worldwide, have been diagnosed to have Alzheimer's disease. Although some Alzheimer's patients are born with dementia, most develop it over time, slowly at first and worsening with age. Like most types of dementia, Alzheimer's disease is progressive. Therefore, the effects of memory loss will increase over time and can result in the loss of lingual and communicative ability. During the later stages of the disease, the parts of the brain associated with focusing, paying attention, reasoning, and making judgments are heavily affected. Alzheimer's disease has no known cure today. What does exist are several options to help alleviate the symptoms and prevent the worsening of the disease. Modern-day medication includes Aricept, Razadine, and Exelon. Each of the active ingredients in these treatments are known to either improve what parts of the brain function under the effects of Alzheimer's disease or hinder any further growth of the disease. The solution for the aforementioned medications are to intensify cell-to-cell communication found within the human brain, which would otherwise be slowed down or stopped by Alzheimer's disease. These active ingredients are called cholinesterase inhibitors. In Aricept, donepezil is used to improve cognition and behavior, but is only effective with mild Alzheimer's disease. In Razadine, the active ingredient galantamine treats various other memory impairments, including Alzheimer's. And then Exelon, rivastigmine is used, known to have positive treatment effects on the cognitive, functional, and behavioral problems commonly associated with Alzheimer's. Another medication used to aid Alzheimer's patients is memantine, which slows the progression of the disease by regulating the activity of glutamate, also known as glutamic acid, which can cluster inside a brain, blocking up neuron pathways and causing receptor desensitization. These medications were developed recently, with Aricept and Exelon approved by the FDA in 2006, Razadine in 2004, and memantine in 2003. However, further investigators have not reaped any useful medication for about a decade. Furthermore, the existing medical procedures only work to slow the progression of the disease and does not rid a patient of Alzheimer's. There is no current treatment able to prevent or completely eliminate AD from patients.
The form of Alzheimer's we are targeting is late-onset AD, which is the most common form of this disease. Unlike early-onset AD, late-onset occurs to people over the age of 65 and may or may not run in families, so its inheritance is more complex. Research has indicated abnormalities in the brain tissue associated with the disease. One such abnormality is caused with a mutation with the amyloid beta precursor protein, or APP, which is a membrane protein found in cells throughout the body, including the brain. The APP normally aids in neural growth and repair and consists of four domains, as is illustrated in the picture. Sets of protease enzymes, or secretases, are responsible for cutting or cleaving the APP into functional fragments. Normally, alpha secretase cuts in the middle of the beta amyloid domain, pictured as green, cutting the APP into three fragments. The top, in purple, is released to help control nerve growth, and the bottom, the blue circle, is sent inside the cell. However, the mutation causes the APP to inhibit alpha secretase cleavage and prefer cleavage by beta and gamma secretase enzymes. When the beta and gamma secretase cleave on either side of the beta amyloid domain, the beta amyloid peptide leaves the membrane and clumps together, or aggregates, into beta amyloid oligomer aggregates. This process, as well as the normal process, is shown in the figure. The oligomer aggregates can form into beta sheet amyloid fibrils, or plaques, which interfere with cell-to-cell communication in the brain, leading to the onset of dementia in AD patients.
During the 1970s, complex modeling was mainly based on manually identifying surface features of interactors. and then understanding the outcomes for binding and a few other activities. Further analysis was limited by the primitive computer programs that were only used at the end of the modeling process. At that time, computer programs could only discriminate between a few configurations. Computers were later used in a study on hemoglobin interaction in sickle cell fibers. This was possible because of work done on the trypsin BPTI complex. In 1978, computers had been advanced enough to discriminate between good and bad models. The computer utilized a simplified representation of the interacting proteins. More complex structures were determined during the 1990s because of further advancements of computer computations. Bioinformatics moved the focus in a new direction towards developing generalized techniques which could be applied to broader sets of complexes at a reasonable price. After the publication of the correlation method in 1992, scalability was improved tremendously for evaluating coarse shape attached to rigid body models. This was furthered in 1997 for coarse electrostatics. Recently, molecular docking has developed into a crucial tool for biochemistry. As a process used in predicting favorable orientation of molecules bound together to form the most stable complex. Analysis of this process can then be useful in predicting the binding affinity between molecules and the effect of ligand receptor proteins. Ligand docking is useful in bioengineering due to its special process of docking small molecule ligands to larger protein receptors. However, medicines containing ligands have found to possibly result in unwanted defects. Thus, experimenting with different ligands on a human or animal to target a specific protein could likely negatively affect their health. So scientists and researchers use software and computational docking to predict the behavior of a ligand with a protein.
The Schrödinger Suites, a set of software used in bioengineering studies, offer a platform of integrated software solutions and services aimed at protein experimentation. Users can observe the effect of combining different compounds and materials through advanced computational techniques rather than laboratory practices. Researchers who work directly with living biological systems will benefit greatly from these resources, as they do not require animal or human patients. Other resources, including time, money, and chemical materials, will also be saved. All of these are goals of the creators who founded the Schrödinger Suites. Of these suites, or programs, we will be using Maestro, the graphical user interface, or GUI, of all computational experimentation. Users can visually test several programs designed specifically for protein synthesis, ligand docking, and other protein functions. Maestro accesses the protein data bank in order to analytically determine the effect of, for instance, docking a ligand onto a protein chain. This program of the Schrödinger Suites, called glide docking, is the function necessary to find ways to denature problematic proteins, including beta amyloid, in Alzheimer's disease.
With the glide program, users can utilize Maestro to see the effects of a docked ligand on a protein, often a chain. In the case of beta amyloid, the shape is a long chain that seems folded. This is a protein's secondary beta sheet structure. To denature a folded sheet-shaped protein, a researcher must be able to find a ligand that causes the protein to either fully uncoil or further bend into a debilitated shape. By docking different ligands onto the beta amyloid sheet on Maestro, we will find a ligand that causes the harmful beta amyloid plaque to lose its shape and ultimately denature the protein. Ligands capable of denaturing beta amyloid via computational docking can be labeled as candidates for in vitro testing to develop drugs that will mitigate or eliminate the effects of AD. We will begin the process of glide docking through Maestro by importing experimental elements from the Protein Data Bank, or PDB. This includes the beta amyloid sheet we will be testing, as well as a ligand library with ligands to dock onto it. The effect of each docked ligand on the beta amyloid itself will be measured qualitatively in terms of whether or not the protein was properly denatured. After these have been prepared, we will move on to the process of glide docking. To initialize the computational function, the beta amyloid sheet must be prepared in such a way that the Maestro program will be able to detect its active sites. The settings will be adjusted to display both the ligand and receptor in a way that is easy to visualize the change in shape of the protein. The active site will then be highlighted and prepared for the ligand docking. In defining the receptor, we must generate a grid on which the ligand and beta amyloid will be centered for better control within the GOI while conducting these computational processes. All aspects of docking, including van der Waals, radii scaling, and receptor grid size, will be adjusted. After all settings for ligand docking have been changed properly, and the visual display settings have been set for maximized visibility of protein shape, we will allow the Maestro program to put ligands to the test. Each experimental ligand will be tested at the active site of the beta amyloid sheet as it was defined in the aforementioned steps. Ignoring ligands that did not meet all requirements and could not dock, the return result of each ligand docked onto the beta amyloid sheet will be analyzed qualitatively. Based on the extent of protein bending and unwinding, we will determine whether or not the plaque has been denatured.
The use of the proposed computational docking technique is an effective method to provide insight on ligands that will properly denature the beta amyloid protein associated with plaque buildup in Alzheimer's disease. The ligands that properly denatured the beta amyloid protein associated with Alzheimer's disease can be used for new medication and treatment of late onset AD. The computational method is more accurate because there are no unwanted reactions to affect the data. Also, the computational environment is represented as bioactive enough for the ligands to properly dock. Sample homogenized brain tissues used in in vitro testing are not bioactive enough. However, these unwanted reactions in in vitro tests are realistic and are a drawback of the computational method because they are not accounted for. When the ligand is tested in vitro, it may have some unwanted effects. The images in the slide show how the computational method and in vitro method have contrasting levels of complexity. The computational method would provide scientists with an idea on which ligands to bring to in vitro testing, saving time wasted on testing ligands that do not properly denature the beta amyloid protein associated with AD causing plaque buildup. In vitro trials would provide insight on other molecules the effective ligands may dock or react with. The in vitro trials would be followed with clinical trials to test how the ligand reacts in a completely bioactive environment, in vivo. Pictured in the slide is a homogenized, thin-sliced brain tissue sample used in AD research. The results of the method could result in advances in degenerative Alzheimer's disease and possibly even a treatment that completely eradicates the effects of AD.